the mathematical background. Till date, we had continued by understanding the theoretical routine, and now here we have to concentrate on the numerical part of our structure. So, friends, let us start slowly, effectively, so that each and everybody will be able to understand the concept more effectively. So, let us start with the concept. If there is anything, you can post in the chat box. If there is any connectivity issue, any problem is there, we can discuss or we can continue directly with our content. So let us start for understanding the mathematical background. As all of we people are knowing that mathematics is the foundation of our engineering concept at a nutshell. And so therefore, we'll start with a vector A bar. Here, as we can observe, A bar is a vector which is described with AX bar component, AY bar component, and AZ bar component. Here we can see that AX bar is having its magnitude capital AX, AY bar is having magnitude capital AY, and AZ bar is having magnitude capital AZ. So friends, in last lecture we had learned vector theory, and in that vector theory we had concentrated on two basic concepts, that is divergence and curl. So what is this divergence? I would like to repeat here. And divergence is nothing but del dot A bar. Now question arises, what is this del? Del is the inverted triangle that you can observe here. The second line, pay attention on the second line. Del dot A bar is nothing but the divergence of A bar with the del parameter. Now del parameter is nothing but d by dx, d by dy, and d by dz, as we can observe on the screen. If A bar is the vector whose divergence is to be calculated, we can write del dot A bar is equal to d by dx of AX component plus d by dy of AY component and d by dz of AZ component. I think the screen is visible to all. If there is any issue related to screen visibility or communication or audio problem, you can post in the chat box or you can unmute your microphone and you can tell us. Okay, so here we are observing that if A bar is any vector, its divergence can be calculated by taking the derivative with respect to x of AX component, derivative with respect to y of AY component, and derivative with respect to z of AZ component. Instead of that, if suppose we are required to calculate the curl of the vector, how we can calculate? We will have to consider the determinant in front of we all. It will be consisting of first row AX bar, AY bar, and AZ bar. Second row for the curl parameters will be d by dx, d by dy, and d by dz. And on the third row, the vector whose curl is to be calculated, its components are expressed. That is nothing but capital AX, capital AY, capital AZ. Here, there is no any sort of confusion that can be created. For that purpose only, we have defined the notations accordingly. Capital AX is the magnitude of vector in X direction. Capital AY is the magnitude of vector in Y direction. And capital AZ is the magnitude of vector in Z direction, or we can say positive Z direction. So after having a look on the divergence and curl parameters, let us continue with the essential basic parameters that are nothing but the components of Maxwell's equation, which can be understood effectively by using these equations. So here, first parameter is nothing but E bar. Though it is not somewhat visible, you can consider it as E bar, as electric flux or field intensity. Electric field intensity is denoted by E bar. Electric flux density is denoted by D bar. Magnetic field density is denoted by B bar. And magnetic field intensity is denoted by H bar. All the four parameters are very much essential for the lecture that we have started today. And to understand the overall concept of Maxwell's equation, these four constituents are appearing many times. Therefore, try to remember these parameters very effectively so that there will not be any confusion in understanding the next slide. So I would like to repeat once again, here E bar and D bar are related to electrical fields, and B bar and H bar are related to magnetic fields. D bar and B bar are the densities, whereas E bar and H bar are the intensities. Further, we have to remember that if suppose a dot is marked on the vector or scalar or any component, that is nothing but the time derivative of that component. That is, if suppose A bar is any field or quantity, if suppose any dot is appearing on it, we have to remember that it is nothing but the time derivative of given parameter. It is being appeared in the next second or third slide. Therefore, it's very important term that we have to remember. Now, few of you people are having confusion that till date it was better. We were learning concept of electromagnetism, applications of electromagnetism, vector theory, all things were simpler. And now it is started with derivative and integration. It is somewhat critical. But friends, it is not like that. Just concentrate on the overall lecture here. And I assure you that every student will be having clarity of the topic. Also, after this lecture, I will provide the recording of this lecture on our EGPIT e-learning. All the students can learn or can observe the same lecture video a number of times, so that concept will be very clear. So let us proceed further. In last lecture also we had seen divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. What is divergence theorem and Stokes theorem that we had seen? If suppose we have to convert a two-dimensional integration, that is double integration, if suppose is required to be converted into triple integral, we can use divergence theorem. Here, as we can observe, that last but second line, A bar dot ds bar. Now, what is this A bar? A bar is any vector field, and ds bar is nothing but the surface integral. Though we have written one integral sign, we have to consider it as the double integration. It is notation. Ds bar indicates double integration. If suppose double integral is required to be converted into triple integral, what is the necessity? We will have to consider the divergence of given vector. Now consider the link. Why I have cleared the concept of divergence on the same slide, upper second line. What is it? Del dot A bar. The same del dot A bar is appearing at the bottom equation of divergence theorem. If a bar dot ds bar is LHS, it will be equivalent to the RHS in which there is a volume integral. But what is the change? The change is that a bar is converted into del dot a bar. Now, to check the presence of all the student, I will ask one question. Any good mathematical student can answer this question. You have to tell me that how it is possible that in divergence of Stokes theorem, single integral is equivalent to double integral, or double integral is equivalent to triple integral. Can anybody tell me? For example, in Marathi, if I will ask question, will be more clear. आपल्याला प्रेझेंटेशनच्या स्क्रीन मध्ये दोन इक्वेशन दिसत आहेत. एक आहे डायव्हर्जन्स थेरम, एक आहे स्टोक्स थेरम. डायव्हर्जन्स थेरम मध्ये आपण बघतोय की सरफेस इंटिग्रल म्हणजे आहे तिथे डबल इंटिग्रल, मध्यभागी आहे इक्वल टू साइन, आणि आर एच एस ला आहे ट्रिपल इंटिग्रल. मग डबल इंटिग्रेशनची व्हॅल्यू ट्रिपल इंटिग्रेशनची इक्विव्हॅलंट कशी काय येऊ शकेल? ऑर द सेम क्वेश्चन कॅन बी रिपीटेड ऍज इन केस ऑफ स्टोक्स थेरम. स्टोक्स थेरम मध्ये पहा, ए बार डॉट डी एल बार आहे एल एच एस मध्ये, म्हणजे ते आहे लाईन इंटिग्रल, आणि आर एच एस मध्ये आहे डेल क्रॉस ए बार इंटू डी एस बार, म्हणजे ते आहे सरफेस इंटिग्रल, म्हणजे आहे डबल इंटिग्रल. सिंगल इंटिग्रलला डबल इंटिग्रेशन डबल इंटिग्रल मध्ये रिप्रेझेंट केलेलं आहे, आणि डबल इंटिग्रलला ट्रिपल इंटिग्रल मध्ये रिप्रेझेंट केलेलं आहे. वेदर इट इज मॅथमॅटिकली करेक्ट or not correct, who will tell me? Many students are present in the class. You can unmute your mic and tell me. No, nobody? Swami? Puranto Swami kay sangta yil ka? Samartha hai? आणखीन वैष्णवी आहे, मानोर आलेले आहे. जस्ट परत एकदा, हु विल टेल मी? शॅल आय रिपीट द क्वेश्चन? लक्ष्मी आहे, दोन लक्ष्मी आहे, आशिष आहे, अंजली. अंजली आय थिंक अंजली कॅन टेल अस. अंजली, अंजली दोन आहेत का क्लासमध्ये? ओके, आय थिंक ऑल हॅव म्युटेड देअर मायक्रोफोन लेक्चर मीटिंग अँड आर गोइंग समवेअर. आदिती इज इट देअर? आदिती, आदिती गिव्ह अटेंडन्स?
येस सर.
ओके, आहे आदिती, ते आहे. चला आणखीन अंजली. अंजली बघा, अंजली आहे का? अंजली गिव्ह अटेंडन्स.
हॅलो
हॅलो अंजली, आहे का तू?
हो सर.
ओके ओके, हा मानवने मानवने आन्सर सांगितलं काहीतरी, डबल इंटिग्रल विथ डबल डेरिव्हेटिव्ह. नो मानव, देअर इज नो एनी डबल डेरिव्हेटिव्ह, ओनली सिंगल डेरिव्हेटिव्ह इज देअर. बट शी इज रिचिंग नियर टू द आन्सर. आपण इथं ऑब्झर्व करतोय की डायव्हर्जन्स थिअरम जरी असेल, तरी जे काही सरफेस इंटिग्रल आपण ऑब्झर्व करतोय त्याच्या इक्विव्हॅलंट व्हॉल्यूम इंटिग्रल म्हणजे ट्रिपल इंटिग्रेशन इंटिग्रल का बरं आहे? कारण ट्रिपल इंटिग्रल जरी असलं तरी एक डेरिव्हेटिव्हची टर्म आहे. ॲज ऑल ऑफ वी पीपल आर नोईंग दॅट इंटिग्रेशन अँड डेरिव्हेटिव्ह आर अपोजिट टर्म्स, ट्रिपल इंटिग्रेशन विथ वन डेरिव्हेटिव्ह टर्म विल बी नथिंग बट डबल इंटिग्रल. इन द सेम वे for the Stokes theorem we can observe that if ds bar is there, it will be a triple integral, but if there is surface integral, there is a double integral, but out of that double integral there is one del cross a bar, that is derivative term. One derivative term and two integral terms will be contributing to one integral term as per our सिम्पलर कन्सिडरेशन. हे ऍक्च्युली तसं नाही आहे, इट इज नॉट दॅट मच इझियर, बट to understand the equations in an easy manner or to remember them more effectively, we can keep in mind like this. Okay, if there is any doubt or confusion, you can ask in between by unmuting your mic, and also it is possible that you can post in the chat box. I think these concepts are very clear to each and everyone. Divergence is there, that is nothing but del dot A bar. Curl can be understood, del cross A bar. Electric field parameters are having two basic aspects, that is E bar and D bar. Electric field intensity is E bar, electric flux density is nothing but D bar. In the same way, magnetic field intensity is H bar, and magnetic field density is denoted by B bar. These are the four essential terms we had to understand. Now let us continue with our main required topic. Okay, we'll proceed further. If it is not visible, is it required to be made somewhat more clear? Just a minute, we'll try to make it more clear. Yes, I think it is somewhat clearer than previous one. So here we have to start with Maxwell's equation, and in case of Maxwell's equation, so we have to start with the first law. So on the screen you can observe, in case of Maxwell's equation, we'll start to understand the Ampere's law. I think many of you people will be having the equation of Ampere's law that we had derived in previous lecture. If suppose you were absent in the last lecture, then also it is possible easily. Just consider here the mathematical part. According to the statement of Ampere's law, we had written the closed loop integral of magnetic flux density, sorry, magnetic flux or magnetic field intensity is equivalent to the current flowing through सर्किट. एम्पियर नावाच्या सायंटिस्टने डिराइव केलेला लॉ असा होता की जे काही करंट फ्लो होणार आहे एका सर्किटमध्ये त्याच्या इक्विव्हॅलंट मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड त्याच्या अक्रॉस डेव्हलप झालेलं असणार आहे. आय थिंक ऍट द टाइम ऑफ 10th स्टँडर्ड ऑल्सो यू माइट हॅव स्टडीड सम एक्सपेरिमेंट इन विच वी हॅड सीन दॅट इफ सपोज करंट इज फ्लोइंग थ्रू अ कॉइल, मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इंड्यूस्ड इन इट. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू एम्पियर्स लॉ, वी कॅन राईट integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to I. Here I is nothing but the current flowing through the circuit. Okay, so first equation that is to be kept in our mind is integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to I. Now keeping it aside, let us proceed further. Also, if j bar, now J bar is the current density. If suppose J bar is the current density over a surface S, similar to Ampere's law, we can write integration J bar dot ds bar is equal to I. What is this J bar? J bar is the current density. As all of you people are knowing that J bar, that is current density over a surface, as we have written on the presentation screen, it is J bar dot ds bar is also equivalent to I, that is current flowing through the circuit. How this equation can be understood? As we know that current density is there, J bar can be defined as di by ds. ds will be getting cancelled, and total current density can be described with the current value I. If suppose first equation and second equation are equated, what we can write? We can write integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to I is equal to j bar dot ds bar. So once again, if suppose I is kept aside, we can write h bar dot dl bar is equal to j bar dot ds bar. Though the screen, if suppose is not clear to you, you can understand the terms by the words that I am going to use for explanation. So the equation in this square box is integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to integration j bar dot ds bar. So this is the first equation used as Maxwell's equation. Now we have to remember that there are four laws, as that we had seen in the last lecture. Maxwell derived, or Maxwell used, four different laws for explaining the behavior of electromagnetic waves. In the same way here, we can observe that if suppose the behavior of any electromagnetic wave is to be expressed, we can express it in terms of integral form, or also it is possible to be expressed in point or differential form. Okay, so what is this point and differential form? That I would like to explain. If suppose any equation is there which is consisting of integral terms, can be considered as the Maxwell's equation in integral form. If suppose equation is consisting of no any integral form, instead of that it is consisting of differential terms, derivative terms, that may be either divergence or curl type or similar, we can consider that equation as a point form or differential form. So here we have to remember that there are four equations used by Maxwell to express the behavior of electromagnetic waves in different media, but equations, instead of four, there will be eight equations, because one equation will be expressed in two forms. One form will be integral form, second form will be differential form. Approximately all question papers that we had referred, or that you can refer, are consisting of at least one question of Maxwell's equation. Therefore, remember this as a very important part. I would like to repeat, integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to I according to Ampere's law. And if suppose j bar is the current density, we can write j bar dot ds bar also is equivalent to I. Equating equations 1 and 2, we can write in the box or in the bracket equation, integration h bar dot dl bar is equal to integration j bar dot ds bar is the first equation of Maxwell equation sets in integral form. Now let us consider the Stokes theorem. As per the Stokes theorem, we know that any vector can be converted into its surface vector, that is, line integral can be converted into surface integral by taking the curl of the vector. Therefore, integration h bar dot dl bar on LHS can also be written as integration del cross h bar into ds bar. So here we can observe that there are three components of the equations. One is h bar dot dl bar is equivalent to double integration del cross h bar into ds bar. Here what we have used? Here we have used the divergence theorem. And according to the divergence theorem, line integral is converted into surface integral by taking the curl. And what is on the right hand side? Right hand side is same as that of j bar dot ds bar as per the equation in integral form. So therefore, if suppose middle part is considered with the end part, the underlying part can be observed here. The both integrals are similar. Here is also ds bar, here is also ds bar. Therefore, removing the surface integral from both sides we can write del cross H bar is equal to J bar. That is nothing but the point form of the Ampere's law, or it can be considered as the second equation from the set of Maxwell's equations. Further, the statement can be converted. Then after deriving these two equations, what scientists found practically that there is a requirement of a small addition to be considered for overcoming the inconsistency of Ampere's law. That is, Ampere's law had required to be corrected as J bar, that is nothing but current density, that can be effectively expressed as J bar plus D bar dot, where it is practically considered that the current density is the combination of conduction current and displacement current, D bar dot. Now, displacement current as will be the current coming into existence due to displacement of electric charges from one place to another place, which will be having consideration of time derivative. Therefore, we can consider here that instead of writing only J bar, we can write J bar plus D bar dot. I think dot is clear to everybody. Dot is nothing but the time derivative of given parameter. Therefore, corrected Ampere's law is expressed as del cross H bar as it is. Instead of writing only J bar, anyone can write J bar plus D bar dot. In case of static fields, D bar dot value will be zero. And again, we could get the original equation, that is del cross H bar is equal to J bar dot or J bar only. So once again, overall Maxwell's equation can be written as in point form or in differential form. Ampere's law of the Maxwell's equations is expressed as del cross H bar is equal to J bar plus D bar dot. And though it is somewhat not clear, the last equation, I think everybody can consider it, because it is same to the equation, first equation in box. That is nothing but H bar dot DL bar is equal to I is equal to, instead of J, here we have written J plus D bar dot. Though screen may not be somewhat clear, if you close your eyes, then also it is possible that you can remember four equations. Integration H bar dot DL bar is equal to I. Integration J bar dot DS bar is equal to I. Therefore, H bar dot DL bar is equal to I is equal to J bar dot DS bar. It is nothing but the first equation of set of Maxwell's equation. The same equation can be expressed as del cross H bar is equal to J bar. Then a small correction to be considered is, scientists found that instead of only considering the current density, which is combination of J bar, it is also having some influence of a displacement current density. Therefore, there is a correction that was added. Instead of writing J bar, we can write J bar plus D bar dot. Therefore, the first screen in front of you is explaining the first set of Maxwell's equation completely. Okay, sometimes question may be explain Ampere's law. You have to write these all parameters effectively, and so by writing the statement, by adding one or two equation if necessary, and you can clarify the complete terminologies related. I think if there is no any doubt, shall we proceed to the next equation? We have to complete four equations today. Out of that, first equation is over, which was very much lengthier. Other three equations are smaller. if there is something that you can you will have to express, you can tell us, or you can tell me. Okay, so proceeding further, we'll move to the second law, that is nothing but Faraday's law. In previous lecture also we had seen that Faraday had expressed the laws which stated its equation EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt. What were Faraday's law? Faraday's laws were stating the equations that whenever magnetic flux associated with any coil is changing, an EMF is induced in the coil, was the first law. In the same way, second law was expressing that the rate of change of magnetic flux is directly proportional to the EMF induced. And third law was stated that the EMF which is developed is in the opposite direction to the flux which produces it. So here the first equation EMF is equal to minus d phi by dt, that can be observed here. Then if suppose a B bar, as we know that B bar is magnetic flux density, EMF induced can be given as phi is equal to B bar dot ds bar. Whatever is the magnetic flux density, that can be defined, that can be defined as the integration of, or surface integration of magnetic flux density over the surface is nothing but phi. Therefore the phi can be substituted in the upper equation. We can write E bar dot dl bar as the LHS is equal to EMF is equal to minus d by dt as it is, into the value of phi can be stated as integration B bar dot ds bar. Again, the time derivative can be changed by the dot. I think everybody is able to observe the dot present here. Therefore, we can write the equation as integration E bar dot dl bar is equal to minus as it is integration B bar dot ds bar. This is nothing but the integration or integral form of the Faraday's law out of Maxwell's equation. Again, by considering the line integral to be converted into surface integral, we can write E bar dot dl bar as del cross E bar into ds bar. The right hand portion, the right hand side portion as it is, minus B bar into integration B bar dot ds bar as it is. We can write integration E bar dot dl bar as del cross E bar into ds bar. Therefore, removing the surface integrals from both sides, we can write del cross E bar is equal to minus B bar dot, which is nothing but the point form of the Maxwell's equation. I think this will be more simpler, because in case of first equation only, as I had stated, the Ampere's law was somewhat lengthier than other laws. Therefore, considering simply, Faraday's law is expressed in two set of equations. That is nothing but integration E bar dot dl bar is equal to minus integration B bar dot ds bar in integral form. And the same equation can be expressed as del cross E bar is equal to minus B bar dot. I think if there is no any issue, we will proceed further. The third law is nothing but Gauss law. We know that total normal electric induction is equivalent to the total charge flowing through the surface. Mathematically, the same law can be expressed as integration D bar dot ds bar is equivalent to the value Q. What is Q? Q is the total charge present in the surface. Now, if suppose rho V, this is nothing but rho. Rho V is nothing but volume charge density. For any charge, we can express Q as the volume charge density is volume integral. If suppose rho v is to be expressed more correctly, we can write rho v is equal to Q upon v, and this integration dv will be equivalent to v. V will be getting cancelled, and Q will be equal to the overall charge. That is, Q can be expressed as in triple integration rho v dv. Remember that though here you are observing only one integral, there is actually triple integral due to dv. It is nothing but volume integration, and everybody know that volume integration will be consisting of three integral in order. Therefore, if suppose these two equations are stated or considered together, Q equivalent to Q, we can write d bar dot ds bar is equal to integration rho v dv, which is nothing but integral form of Gauss law. The same equation, if suppose converted by using divergence theorem, we can write integration d bar dot ds bar, that can be converted into volume integral by taking the divergence law or divergence theorem. Try to recall first screen or first slide of this presentation, we had defined the del dot d bar or del dot a bar. Del dot a bar we had defined, which is equivalent to divergence of given vector. That is, surface integral is converted into volume integral here by consideration of the divergence of given vector. The point form can be expressed therefore as del dot d bar by removing the volume integral from both sides. We can write del dot d bar is equal to rho v, is nothing but third set of equation of Maxwell's equation, which is derived by the Gauss law. Similarly, if suppose magnetic fields are considered, or magnetic effects are considered, as like d bar dot ds bar, we can write. Similarly, we can write b bar dot ds bar, but here its value will be equivalent to zero, because there is no any time varying fields. The overall value of b bar dot ds bar will be equal to zero, and by consideration of surface integral into volume integral, we can write del dot b bar is equal to zero. That is, Gauss law can be studied effectively by two aspects. One is electric field, second is magnetic field. Now let us move or proceed further towards the fourth law, that is nothing but continuity equation. Though it is appearing to be first equation, actually it is fourth equation due to that resolution issue of the image that was taken. So fourth equation is called as continuity equation. It is the last slide of our today's lecture. Try to concentrate on it. We know that current flowing in a circuit can be described as I is equal to J bar dot ds bar, and also I is equal to minus dq by dt. That is nothing but rate of change of flow of charge per unit time. If suppose q is changed by integration rho v dv, we can write d by dt as it is, and integration of writing this q, we have written rho v dv, which is again changed with this dot. That is, time derivative is changed to dot. Therefore, equating the two equations of current, we can write j bar dot ds bar is equal to minus integration of rho v dot dv. Just a minute, wait a moment. Yes, and the same equation, if suppose this surface integral is converted into volume integral, we can write, instead of j bar dot ds bar, it can be replaced with del dot j bar into dv, and again we can write डेल डॉट जे बार इज इक्वल टू माइनस रो वी डॉट. दिस वॉज द पार्ट ऑफ मैक्सवेल्स इक्वेशन दैट वी हैव टू कंसिडर. डेफिनेटली बाय लिसनिंग टू दिस लेक्चर ओनली इट विल नॉट बी सफिशियंट टू अंडरस्टैंड एवरी इक्वेशन मोर इफेक्टिवली. इट विल बी होमवर्क फॉर यू टू ऑल दैट यू हैव टू डिराइव फोर मैक्सवेल्स इक्वेशन बाई योर ओन ऑन अ प्लेन पेपर. टेक अ सिंपल पेपर ऑन विच यू हैव टू स्टार्ट राइटिंग. जस्ट स्टार्ट विथ डिफाइनिंग डेल डॉट ए बार, डेल क्रॉस ए बार, ई बार, बी बार, एच बार एंड एच बार एंड बी बार वैल्यू. देन यू कैन कंटिन्यू विद द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. It is Ampere's law. Ampere's law can be stated in point form as well as in the integral form. Then on the new paper, just continue with the Faraday's law. Express Faraday's law in integral form and also in the differential form. Then proceed to the Gauss law. Express it in electric field as well as in the magnetic field. Then proceed to the continuity equation. Try to derive it effectively. Then after deriving these four equations effectively, then try to understand or try to listen once again these four equations. I think everybody will be having clarity of the all equations without any mathematical issues. Also, after this lecture, I will publish this video on YouTube channel, as well as the same presentation can be shared with all the students, which will be useful for all. So I think there is a very much of time that we have consumed today. We have started somewhat late, but I think each and every student was attentive and sincere, so that he have understood all the equations more correctly. So let us stop here. Stay safe, stay at home. Thank you.
Yeah.